Hello and welcome to Peculiar Journeys with Pastor Jael. I'm Pastor Jael. This is my peculiar journey. We are back with our series on the armor of God. Bum, bum, bum. Yes, the armor of God. We're back. So let's read our key verses for this series, which comes from Ephesians chapter 6. Let's take a look. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10 says, "Finally, let the Lord make you strong. Depend on His mighty power." That's right. His mighty power, Mr. Zeph. Not our mighty power, but His mighty power. "Put on all of God's armor." Not just a couple of pieces, but all of God's armor. All of God's armor. "Then you can remain strong against the devil's evil plans." Our fight is not against human beings. Sometimes it feels like it is, right? Sometimes it's like, whoa, but these people, you don't even know, Pastor Jael. I know, but remember, we're not fighting against human beings. Let's see what happens here. "We are," it says, "against rulers and the authorities and the powers of this dark world. It is against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly world." So, verse 13, "Put on all of God's armor. Evil days will come, but you will be able to stand up to anything." Garcia family, did you hear that? You'll be able to stand up to anything when you put on God's armor. "And after you have done everything you can, you will still be standing. So remain strong in the faith. Put on the belt of truth around your waist. Put the armor of godliness on your chest. Wear on your feet what will prepare you to tell the good news of peace. Also, pick up the shield of faith. With it, you can put out all the flaming arrows of the evil one." All right. So here's what we're going to talk about today. First, recap. Okay. We have the belt of truth. Truth, truth, truth. Okay. Belt of truth, right? Belt of truth. Belts, super important, right? Keep your pants up if your pants are a little loose. But belt of truth, why is the belt of truth important? Because it's the anchor, right? Just like a belt is the anchor to, you know, hold up your pants. But even for soldiers, the soldiers had the belt as an anchor. So this belt was an anchor that was holding together the breastplate of righteousness, which we'll talk about in a minute. So the breastplate, but also it had a holster for the sword. So that's the anchor. The anchor is truth. And we know that the truth is the Word of God. That's right. Okay, next one we talked about was the breastplate of righteousness, right? Breastplate of righteousness. Where's this going? It's protecting our organs, right? Your vital organs, like your heart, your lungs, all the things, right? Here's the thing. What did we learn? We need to guard our heart, protect our heart, right? How can we do that? Guys, you know where I'm going. By reading your Bible, know what God's word says, know what the truth says. And then the week after that, we talked about the shoes of peace, right? The shoes for the preparation of the gospel of peace. And we learned something pretty cool about these shoes. These shoes actually have nails. Nails on the bottom, right? That's what the soldiers had at that time. They had nails on the bottom. It was kind of like cleats, right? So it helped you have traction. So that way, no matter if the surface was unsteady or, you know, the ground was wet or slippery, the soldiers wouldn't slip around. And so here's what we know is that when we know the truth of God's word, we have a firm foundation. So no matter what crazy thing this world is talking about that might make people slip and might make people lose traction, we know that God's word, right? It all goes back to the word of God. God's word is going to keep a steady and a firm foundation, right? We know the truth of God's word. All right, today. That was a pretty good recap. I'm very proud of us. That was good. Here's what we're learning about today. We talked about the, here it is. This is the zoomed in one because I couldn't find just the breastplate of righteousness, but the breastplate of righteousness. No, that's not the breastplate of righteousness. Whoa, the shield of faith. Amen. Guys, it's been a long day already. It's okay. The shield of faith. Now you might be looking at that and say, Pastor Jael, what is that fire on there? Well, let's look what the word says. That verse right there in verse 16, it says, "Also pick up the shield of faith. With it, you can put out all the flaming arrows of the evil one." So take a look at this soldier. correct way. Bam! Look at that soldier. He's ready. He is ready for battle. You see? You see how he has some arrows? And those arrows are on fire, right? I don't know about you, but I don't really want a flaming arrow to be shot at me. But here's the thing. He has the shield of faith. So, let's talk about that shield. Notes, guys. Always get your notes. Do your studying. So, a shield was used to detect attacks from the enemy. So, they used the shield knowing like, I mean, if you got hit on the shield, you're like, the enemy's out there, right? So they use the shield to detect an enemy, but also this shield was used to push the enemy back. So it was used like, get out of here, right? Pushing the enemy back. And then here's the thing, the shield of faith, okay? So not the shield of wishing, no. The shield of, we'll try this. No, the shield of faith, right? And so faith is believing in God and trusting in his word, even though we can't see it, right? And so we know like Hebrews 11:1, right? To trust in the Lord. Even if you can't see, we're trusting in the Lord. And so how can we do that? We stand firm on God's word. I'm telling you guys, everything goes back to the Bible. Everything goes back to knowing what God's word says. That's why it's important that we read God's word. Hey, if somebody's telling me something, I want to know what they want to say, right? If God's speaking to us, let's know what he says, right? Because he's speaking to us. So when it says, take up the shield of faith, right? Let me get my shield. Take up the shield of faith. I got the shield of faith, right? Take up the shield of faith. That means to stand firm on God's word. Know what God's word said. So when that flaming arrow of discouragement comes at you, right? You're like having a good day and then it's like, bam! Oh, got hit by discouragement, right? But the shield of faith stops it because we know what God's word says. So let's say, for example, you have that flaming arrow of discouragement and it's saying this, it's saying, does God really love you? Right? And then you start thinking, oh man, does God really love me? But if we know what God's word says, we've got that shield of faith. What does God's word say about that? Check this. Romans chapter 5, verse 8. But here is how God has shown his love for us. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Boom, right there. Shield of faith is up. Bam, blocking that arrow saying, does God really love you, Pastor Jael? Does God really love you, Miss Susan? Yes, God really loves you. How do we know? Word of God says right here. But here is how God has shown his love for us. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Let me tell you something. Jesus died for us and gave up his life because he loved us. He likes us too, which is pretty cool. But he loves us. So we know, I know God loves me, right? He gave his life for me. So with that, let's pray together. Lord Jesus, I thank you that you are so, so good. Lord, I thank you for your shield of faith. I thank you for your love, Lord God, that no matter what goes on in our life, when those flaming arrows come at us, telling us lies, we know that we can stop those lies with the truth of your word. And so we thank you for that. We give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. And I hope you have a beautiful day. Remember that every day with God is an adventure. So let's live God's adventures together and get in your word. Get in your word because, hey, we gotta hold up that shield of faith, right? And we need to know what God's word says about it. I love you all. Have a beautiful day. And I will see you next time. Next week, I'm gonna let you know. Next week, helmet of salvation. That's all I'm saying. It's gonna be incredible. Okay, next week, helmet of salvation. I'll see you later. Bye. Oh, also, this Sunday, September 22nd, and if you're watching this after the 22nd, it's already passed. Okay, but this Sunday, September 22nd, 3 to 7 p.m., Higher Vision Valencia Kidventure, we are having a family prayer gathering, okay? So families, come. It's going to be super amazing, super awesome. We're going to be praying together. There's different prayer stations in all the classrooms. If you're like, I don't even know what that means, show up. It's going to be super awesome anytime between 3 and 7. That's all I have to say. Thank you so much. I'll see you later. All right. Bye, everybody. See ya.